What's happening, my fellow brothers and sisters of iron? It's me, your boy, Peter Keller from Fringe Sport here in my garage gym in Austin, Texas. I have got a bar here set up at about bench height because I just finished benching. I'm also wearing my favorite silky short shorts. Do not comment about them in the comments. Do not. And I'm a little bit sweaty because I just finished doing the best thing you can possibly do in a garage gym, which is to say, getting my lift on. What I want to talk to you about today is a couple of barbell basics. If you are a newbie into barbell sport, into the iron game, into the life, as we like to call it, first of all, welcome! You're my type of person. But second of all, I want to tell you just a little bit about barbells so that you can understand some of the basics for why you might want to use a better barbell or even a couple of things about bars in general. Now, normally, I might even show you on a Fringe Sport barbell, but I'm not. I am showing you on this vintage York barbell. This barbell is a barbell that I bought used. It's from the 80s. I got it from some guy in Ohio. And the story that I tell myself, the head canon of this bar, I tell myself that Arnold lifted on it. And every time that I wrap my hands around this bar, I think Arnold put in the reps with this bar, and PK, so can you. So let's talk a little bit about the bar. The very first thing to know is that a bar typically has two major components. We've got the shaft, that's the part that you grab, and we've got the sleeve, that's the part that you load plates onto. One thing that is confusing for people who are new to our game, and if you're building out a garage gym, is that this is what's called an Olympic barbell. Now that can mean a few things, but generally what it means is that this sleeve diameter is 50 millimeters, or as some people sometimes say on eBay or Facebook or Craigslist, 2 inches. So the reason that's confusing is that there's another barbell called the standard barbell, and the standard barbell actually has a smaller diameter sleeve. But if you are really looking to be in the iron game, you actually want an Olympic barbell because you want those 50 millimeter sleeves. You don't want a standard barbell because a standard barbell is really generally quite a bit lower quality than an Olympic barbell, and it's also going to be less fun to lift on because of that low quality, and you're not going to be able to load as much weight on it. So stay away from standard barbells, go for an Olympic barbell. Okay, another couple of things that you might want to learn about barbells. Almost all Olympic barbells share the same length collar to collar, and this allows them to be racked on a squat rack, like I'm in here, so that you can do bench presses, squats, all those other things that you're gonna do on a squat rack. So unless you buy a special purpose barbell, you're not gonna have a bunch of variation in length inside the sleeves. That said, what you might see some variation on is you might see the loadable length on these sleeves. Some bars have thicker collars and some have thinner collars, which affects the loadable length on these sleeves, which means with a barbell with a not long loadable length on the sleeve, you may be constrained in the amount of weight that you can put on here. That said, if you are a new lifter, I would not worry about the length of the sleeves. You're gonna be fine. Once you start building up some strength, then you need to start worrying about it. But we're not talking about a year's journey here. We're talking about 2, 3, something like that before you really are gonna start worrying about loading those sleeves up. And some people never worry about it. So I'm just letting you know, don't worry about that too much. The other big difference that you're gonna see is in the diameter of the shaft. So again, the shaft is what you grab your hands on. There can be a decent amount of variation from 25 millimeters in shaft diameter, which if you have average size hands is gonna feel small, to about 32 millimeter shaft diameter, which is gonna feel a little chonky in those hands. And actually, the shaft can get even larger for strongman type implements, but let's not worry about those right now. Generally speaking, if you are an average adult male, you're gonna wanna look for a sleeve diameter of around 28 to 30 millimeters, probably gonna be your sweet spot there. And if you are a female or maybe even a teen who's trying to get the iron game, you might wanna consider a 15 kilo bar that is gonna have a 25 millimeter shaft diameter. So it's gonna be thinner to put your hands around it. Now I just said kilos in there. I know, we're in America! Speak American, man! But I will tell you that even though the plates for most American lifters, I hear you Olympic lifters, don't get mad at me, but the plates for most American lifters are gonna be denominated in pounds. However, many, if not most, barbells are gonna be denominated in kilograms. So a quote-unquote men's bar is typically 20 kilograms or 44 pounds. Although, in another bit of gym arcana, most people consider it 45 pounds, but it's not. 20 kilos is about 44 pounds. And then most female bars, quote unquote, are going to be 15 kilos or about 33 pounds. Although again, for easy math, many people call them, quote unquote, 35 pounds. Now, I know what you're saying, or maybe you're not, but I am gender nonconforming. I'm not gonna use a men's bar or a women's bar. And to you, I say, go for it. Use whatever bar makes you happy. Traditionally, a 15 kilogram bar is called a women's bar because the International Weightlifting Federation specs it in as a women's weight. But I know you. You are a rule breaker. You take the road less traveled and you use whatever bar you want. But just to let you know, you would commonly see 20 kilo bars called men's bars and 15 kilo called women's bars. But I am a man, but I'm man enough to use a 15 kilo bar. It doesn't matter, whatever you like. One other thing to note about a 15 kilo bar is that they do tend to have smaller sleeves. So you're gonna be able to load a little less weight on them. Okay, so we've talked about shaft diameters. We've talked about the width in here. Something else to note about the shaft is knurling. No, not curling, not purling, not whatever. Knurling. K-N-U-R-L-I-N-G. Knurling. Or, as many people call it, cross hatches. So the cross hatch on the bar is called knurling. And for a beginner, there's really only two things to know or to think about with knurling. Number one is it aggressive? Is it mild? Is it somewhere in between? And if you grab a bar and it feels fine in your hands, don't think about it any more than that. That's good. But I will tell you that power lifters traditionally like very aggressive. They even call it cheese grater knurling because they want to get their hands on that bar and then they don't ever want that bar to get out of their hands unless they want to put it down. And on the other end of the spectrum, so power lifters, they're trying to lift a lot of weight once. So the other end of the spectrum is people like CrossFitters or Waters. They tend to like medium to mild knurling. So as a power lifter does boom, boom, one lift and they're done, a CrossFitter does boom, 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 and they keep going. So they don't want super aggressive knurling, otherwise it's gonna create calluses and tear up their hands. That said, if you're just starting and you grab a bar and it feels fine, lift that bar, you're good. The other thing to keep in mind as far as knurling or cross-hatching goes is where is it? Typically, there are rings in the bar that are gonna help you to see where to set up your hands. If you're setting up for a squat, if you're setting up for a deadlift, you're setting up for a bench, you're setting up for anything. So you might look to see where are those rings and how does that match your body's natural wingspan. The power lifters typically prefer one set of rings, the Olympic weightlifters another, and then the CrossFitters, a combination of the two. Additionally, another thing to look at when you look at knurling, is there knurling down the middle of the bar? Some people like it, some people don't. Again, if you're a beginner and you don't really care one way or another, it doesn't matter. If you like the bar, it's cool. That said, CrossFitters and Water types typically don't prefer knurling in the middle of the bar. And the reason for this is they often wad with their shirts off, and they don't want the knurling chewing up those beautiful lats that they build. Power lifters, on the other hand, usually like very aggressive knurling in the middle of the bar. And that's because a lot of times power lifters will go boom, boom, chalk up their shirts, and they want to lock that bar in. So they tend to like a nice aggressive knurl in the middle. All right, couple of other things to keep in mind if you're a newbie on the bar. Another thing that can be important is the spin around the collars. Now, again, if you're a beginner and you pick up a bar and the bar feels fine, you're probably gonna be fine with it. However, if you wanna get a little technical on that spin, if you believe that you are gonna be doing mostly the slow lifts, and of the slow lifts, they're the big three, bench, squat, deadlift, you're probably gonna want a bushing barbell. It's a barbell that has a bushing in it that has relatively slow spin. If you are an Olympic weightlifter, a wadder, a CrossFitter, or someone who's doing high reps that are going, well, sorry, not high reps, someone who is doing reps from the ground to the shoulder, or from the shoulder to overhead, or from the ground to overhead, you're gonna want a bar that has a faster spin around the collar. The reason for this is, if you're doing bench, squat, dead, the slow lifts, you really don't need that much rotation. Think about it. If you're doing a bench, the bar goes down and up. There's not much need for rotation. You're doing a squat, down and up. Deadlift, down and up. Not much rotation. However, if you're an Olympic lifter, the bar starts at the ground and then you pull, boom, pop underneath it. The bar is describing a rotation in the air. And so you want it to rotate quickly, predictably, and cleanly to get to your shoulders. Same if you're doing ground to overhead. That said, if you're buying a quality bar, you're probably gonna be okay no matter what. For example, any of the main line bars that we sell at Fringe Sport are gonna treat you really well. All right, I'm gonna finish on just one more thing. Why might you want to buy a more expensive bar versus a less expensive bar? There are a bunch of different reasons why you might wanna spend more money on a barbell, but I'm only gonna give you one today to end up this call. A more expensive bar tends to be created with more thought in the design, produced with more quality control and attention to detail, and sold by a company that understands the iron game and what you're doing. And because of this tale of design, production, and distribution, a more expensive bar tends to be a joy to lift on. Instead of thinking about this, that, or the other, someone's already thought about this. They've thought about how deep the knurling should be, and they can guide you on that. They've thought about the spin around the collars. They've thought about the tolerances for the bar, all these things. So when you go to your pain cave, or your man cave, your garage gym, you know that that barbell is your own personal Excalibur. It is there for you to fight with mean old Mr. Gravity. It's for you to do some violence on iron, and it is your Excalibur, your lightsaber, your sharpshooter. It is your partner in the iron game. I've been lifting for 15 years. I've lifted on crappy bars, and I've lifted on the most expensive bars that you can buy. The weight goes down and up on a crappy bar, kind of the same as it does on an expensive bar. I can't say that if you spend $800 or $1,000 on a bar, it's gonna make you stronger and it's gonna make the weight go up easier. But I love lifting, and I love the iron game, and lifting on a well-thought-out, well-manufactured, well-designed bar is a joy. That said, if you decide to lift on any bar, you are my type of people.